Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series deals with working on various CGI render passes in Autodesk Smoke. If you have been through the previous videos, you would have gotten to the stage where we have completed the composite. All the compositing steps that you did were in scene linear color space. To complete and output this composite back to HD video, we need to convert our composited result back into video color space. If you have not already done so, go back to frame 1. Hover over the action schematic and press Ctrl Escape to return back to the ConnectFX schematic. Click the Effects Node button to bring up the ConnectFX node bin. Hover over the node bin and press L for LUT Editor. Drag out the LUT Editor node and place it after the Action node. Connect the output of the action into the input of the LUT Editor. Now double-click on the LUT Editor node to bring up its controls. Change the mode from Gamma to Color Transform. Press Import to enter into the file browser. Choose the Tone Map folder. In the beginning of this series, we applied an inverse tone map to the video background to shift the video color space into scene linear color space. This time, choose the Photomap Gamma 2.4 color transform. This shifts the scene linear color space input into video color space. So the LUT editor is physically remapping the color values. However, our viewer is now looking incorrect with the LUT editor node selected in the ConnectFX schematic. Anything before the LUT editor node will look correct with the color transform applied to this viewer. Now that the color space in the LUT editor is the appropriate video colors, we need to tell the viewer to show the colors correctly. In the viewer, change the color space from linear photo map to video. The color values should look correct again, but the colors are now mapped in video color space. This is ready to be rendered. Just before that, let's double check the colors of the original video background against the composited result. We will use contextual views to do this. In the ConnectFX schematic, hold Ctrl Command and pan the ConnectFX schematic to the video background. Hover over the video background source node. Hold Dash and click on the source node. The context one will be assigned to this node. Now pan back to the LUT editor node at the top of the node tree. Select the node so that its result appears in the viewer. You could toggle between Ctrl 1 and F4 to flick between the contextual view and the result view. Or you could select the viewer and press the Compare button to enable the split bar. This is mapped to Ctrl B on the keyboard. So if you're looking at the result view in this viewer, change the Compare pull-down menu to Context 1. You can now grab the split bar at the bottom of the frame and adjust the split angle. You can also grab the little box in the corner of the frame and move the split bar entirely. This is just to show you that we went from a video color space to a scene linear color space, and then back again to a video color space with all the color values intact. Remember to turn off the compare button when you're done. And at the end of the node tree, connect your final node output into the CFX output node. The result goes out of ConnectFX into the segment residing in the sequence. Press Exit to return back to the sequence. Press the Render button to start the final processing. So there is our CGI integrated with our video background. Remember, if you have a lot of these shots in a production, you can save the ConnectFX node trees and reuse them. Just swap out the live action plates and the CGI render passes, and you have a structure to start working with. More videos on working with CGI passes in Autodesk Smoke will be added in the future. I hope you've enjoyed this video series so far. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.